is crooked.
Don't you do like an intro or something?
Hi. Can I have two of your fried house salads? Mediterranean on both.
Anything else?
Yeah, drinks. I want a Sprite and then
get a sweet tea.
A sweet tea.
Here you go, sweetie.
You have a good day.
Thank you, you too. This is gonna be a thumbnail.
Oh. Your mint box.
Hi guys, it's Jasmine. Welcome back to my channel. I haven't uploaded in probably, I think it's been 2 months since I uploaded last. However, my last video is doing really well. It's my room tour, which I no longer stay in because, you know, we were all kicked off campus due to the coronavirus. We're eating Zaxby's today, and I just want to sit down and I just want to catch up with you guys on the chaos and the misfortune that is my life in this first world problem situation. I want to start off by saying I understand that a lot of people don't have, you know, they're not as fortunate as I am when it comes to wealth, and I'm not trying to brag in any way. I just want to sit down and talk with you guys about my problem. What's today?
Wednesday
the what?
15th.
Okay, so today is Wednesday the 15th. On March Thursday, I think it was the 12th, it was like 6 p.m. and my school sent all of us on campus an email that said, you guys have until 3 p.m. tomorrow to get the off campus, but only plan for 2 weeks. I'm sorry, hold on. I'm so hungry. I haven't eaten all day and it's 3 p.m. I was at Volkswagen today for 3 hours. How was it?
It's good.
Yeah.
I'm really hungry.
And Zaxby's has my second favorite salad. My first favorite, the chicken Caesar salad whole.
Hello.
You're so rude.
Yes, this is Faith. I'm good, how are you? Oh, wow. No, I'm down in Savannah now because they, like, you know, kicked us out. Okay, thank you.
So the National Guard just called me
and tried to recruit me.
I realized that. I was like, what job asked her for her weight and her height? And I was like, that's the army? That's so funny. And what was his initial statement? I just got off the phone with your mother?
Yeah. Don't sound like I'm signing my life away, so.
But hear me out. I'm not trying to turn you from the military, of course. I'm pro-military.
I'd rather go into like the Air Force or the Army, though.
Well, that's the Army National Guard.
What?
The National Guard isn't a branch. The National Guard is like a part of one of the real branches.
No. I heard National Guard. I just got off the phone with your mother. Like.
Hey, for the new viewers, this is my sister Faith. My older one.
Hello.
But anyway. Back to the story. I hope you guys are doing well in this coronavirus times. So today's the 15th. And I bought my first car with cash.
A few weeks ago, not today, for clarification.
On March 13th or 14th. So it's only been a month. Literally the day that I drive it off the lot, issues. Issue after issue after issue. My tires are flat, the engine light's on, the traction control light's on, all this. The first thing, my tires are flat. All four needed to get replaced immediately.
off the lot.
So I go to Goodyear and they give me a diagnostic which cost me $115. when I had already received two diagnostics from O'Reilly and AutoZone. I literally received five diagnostics and I paid for three of them. And they all said the same thing. Top of that, it's like $300. I got $700 tires because my mom swore up and down that I needed the performance ones. You need the really good tires, you need really good tires. Me listening to her, I don't know why. I bought the tires. And like the tires are great. The tires are great. And for some reason, my low tire pressure light's on and the traction control light's on. But when I spoke with the guy at the dealership today, he said that that's because of the issue that I have with the engine. So I was thinking, like, I just got these tires, I'm already having issues, but it's because of the engine that's sending all these misfires all over the place and my car doesn't know what to do. So then on top of that, I spent $666 to get something fixed. I don't even know what they did. I mean, I have the receipt, but like, it didn't fix the problem. So now we're at $1,700, all within 1 month of me owning this car. So today, I go in and I get the diagnostic at Volkswagen because no one else knows how to fix this freaking car. So I was like, let me take it to the people who freaking produce the cars. Volkswagen. Somebody who specializes in this make only. I go to Volkswagen. They take 3 hours to look at the car. I didn't eat before I went. Make sure you eat before you go to a freaking car place because it takes forever. And they come back out and they're like, so whoever was messing with your car shouldn't have been under the hood because they literally just put like misplaced parts and like just everything was just not where it should have been. And I'm just looking at him like, you're telling me somebody just in my car. I also had a recall, but the mechanic fixed that for free, but I still pay for the diagnostic. But however, at Volkswagen they said the diagnostic will go towards me fixing the car. I have to buy a new timing chain kit, which will cost $2,700. I paid $4,900 for this car plus tax. It was less than $5,300 after all. I will literally have paid $9,000 for the car and then fixing the car when I could have just bought a $9,000 car that had no problems. You know what I'm saying? So just learn from my mistakes, guys. Take a mechanic with you if you're gonna buy a used car. Or get a warranty. I didn't get a warranty. I literally bought it as is, no warranty. I was just so excited to have my first car. But the guy at Volkswagen told me that whenever I make the appointment, I need to give him some days in advance because it's gonna take a couple days to order the parts. However, it'll take a couple days to fix the problem. So they will give me a car to use for the time being. And that's what I'm excited about. I'll be whipping around in a 2020 Volkswagen, whatever the heck. That's my life right now. No job. I'm applying. I applied to a lot of them though. I tried to stay in like technology and like IT. So I hit up Verizon and I hit up AT&T. AT&T told me no. Verizon told me no in two separate emails. Like, they sent me one initially and they sent me another one just to make sure that I understood that I didn't get the job. I applied to Planet Fitness. They had an on the phone interview and then they told me that they're gonna schedule an interview with me and the manager once the coronavirus calms down, but no one knows when that is and I need money now. I applied at Gate Petroleum. The gas station in Rincon.
Oh, the gate. Oh, I didn't know that was the whole name. I was like, what?
Yeah, so I applied for a gas station.
I don't care what it is. There's a shooting there or something. Oh, yeah. No. Shooting. Yeah.
The world is just in chaos.
They're still getting robbed.
Oh my god! I've taken up a lot of running though, and a lot of exercising. I'm trying to become a fitness guru. I'm currently working on my own little fitness challenge, 30 day. I've been running a lot though, running a lot. I ran a half marathon, it's out of the blue one day. Like one day I ran 5 miles. And I was like, okay, let me see if I can do 7. Did 7. And then I was like, well, if I can do 7, I can do 10. And if I can do 10, why not do 13.1, which is a half marathon. So one day I just go out and I hit that 5 mile mark. And I was like, okay, we can do 7. hit 7. I'm like, all right, 10. And then 13.1. And I was so sore at the end. My knees were buckling. I was limping back to my car. It was bad. I couldn't even use the stairs because my knees hurt so bad. That's the only good thing Corona has brought me. That, and of course, a lot of my assignments were extended because classes were pushed online and like people needed more time or something. I don't know. Anything exciting in your life? Besides the National Guard?
I joined a sorority. I am now.
Oh, you can talk so much about this dang sorority all the time, but when it matters most for content, I'm in a sorority. And
I joined
Sigma Lambda Gamma.
Say it out loud, guys.
It's so fun to say.
Incorporated.
It's actually pretty cool. Like, they gave her a lot of cool like clothes and stuff.
But Jasmine also joined a sorority.
Oh, no.
Mine is multicultural, by the way.
I'm in DPhi-E, which is the abbreviation for Delta Phi Epsilon. Oh, I also became an orientation leader, but we're doing it online due to the virus. So it's not going to be in person until probably the fall. But yeah. I also got my first tattoo. It's just number 2. She got number 1. Did your watch cover yours?
Mm-hmm.
It's not supposed to.
Well, no, it doesn't, but like my watch slides. But I barely wear my watch. Like,
exactly.
I wear the watch half the
time. I wanted her to admit it. My mom and her. It never used
I wanted watches. It because everyone else had it. That's exactly why I wanted.
Have you guys heard the Weeknd's new album? I literally listened to it on repeat multiple times throughout the day. But when I listen to music, or like a new album, I listen to it in order. She likes to shuffle the album.
After I've heard it straight through, like I'll play it straight through, but after I know it, why not just shuffle it?
No. I have to play in order because it's just all like one big song. So I know exactly what song comes after each song because it's just all one. Dear Jasmine, you need to claim your free celeb endorsed keto sample tonight or it expires. All right, scammer. Sheila Flay. Starboy was a really good album. Anyway, what's your guys' favorite song on After Hours? Mine right now, well, initially it was Blinding Lights because I love that song as a single, and then I liked After Hours as a single, and I loved Heartless as a single. But once the entire album came out, my favorite song was Save Your Tears, is that what it's called?
Mm-hmm.
But now, no, and then it was Missed You, but right now it's Until I Bleed Out.
Yeah, Until I Bleed Out.
Yeah.
My favorite song initially before the album was Blinding Lights, and then it was Hardest to Love.
Yeah.
But now I really like In Your Eyes, but like there's a lot of like good ones, like, you know, every time it just plays, I'm just like,
this, the entire album is just full of good ones. Like In Your Eyes is really good
because that saxophone is just like
Too Late. Final Lullaby. Oh,
Nothing Compares. I do like Nothing. Faith.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's play a song.
Should I shuffle and see what comes?
Yeah,
up?
Shuffle. This is the one time I recommend shuffling. Wait, let me guess. Let me guess what song it is. It's not Snow Child. Escape from LA?
Yes, it is.
Hey! I love you, The Weeknd! I know
you got it in like 18 seconds.
I had to think of how the song goes. song is this? Don't
you,
tell me.
You know what this is.
Too late.
Yeah.
Hey. Savory Tears? No. It's, don't tell me. I know because I know the chorus. Scared Love Again.
Yeah.
Love Again.
Yeah.
This one has to be playing though, because I love the song. Because I have a sign that shouldn't let you go. But I kept you beside me.
Repeat after me. Interlude.
Okay. Oh, repeat after me? Are you kidding me? I wasn't gonna guess that. Take off my faith.
Are you disrespectful or what?
No. Take off my Alone Again.
Yes.
Missed you.
Heartless
Again.
Faith. Yes, that was good. That was like 2 seconds.
This is, oh my god, this is the one before Missed You.
That's true.
Oh, it's not Follow, like Follow was last. This one's like Nothing Compares.
Yep.
Okay. Took his time with this album. He really did. It's amazing. blinding lights.
Yeah.
Is that bleed out?
Yep. 8 seconds.
I was like, it can't be. It can't be. My favorite one. Just let us have it.
Songs, mine except for one. Process of elimination.
Don't be like that.
Final lullaby. Yes. 7 seconds. But y'all can't tell me that that jazzed up harmonica didn't go crazy in the last song.
I'm catching up with you guys again. I hope you really enjoyed catching up with us. Keep listening to the Weeknd's album. It's number one. It's been on number one for the top. It's been number one on the top charts for the past 3 weeks. So
let us know your favorite song in the comments.
Yeah. Comment anything below. Literally put anything you want in the comments, and I will respond. And maybe even comment something for me to do because I'm freaking bored. Okay. Comment prayers for my car, Cash, because she needs as much help as she can get. Be good, practice social distancing, wash your hands, all that good stuff. We will make it out of this, okay? Be strong. See you guys next time.